Hi, I'm Ankit Chaplot and I'm from Udaipur. I'm born and brought up in Udaipur, and I have my father, mother, my wife and me. We all live together in Udaipur. And I am the owner of Cafe Foogle, located in Panchwati, Udaipur. Yeah, in 2009, I completed my graduation in electrical engineering from Gitanjali Institute of Technical Studies. And after that, I did a job for 8 months, company called Vikas Controller Switch Gears, where I worked for 8 months, which deals in LT and ST panels. Then afterwards, I thought of moving further. Without giving a second thought, I just left the job and went for doing the course of automation. So I am a certified automation engineer as well. Then after doing the course, I realized that why not to study further. And then I started my journey by doing the master's in electrical engineering from CTE college. After my completion of my post-graduation, I taught in Pacific Institute of Engineering and Career Point University for 1.5 years, and left the job as a HOD in electrical department. But I just thought that why not start your own business. So in this regard, I just left my job and moved to Goa, where my brother-in-law and my sister lived there. And we started to start a new venture of modular kitchen, as the scope is very good in Goa. So I did that business for around 5 years. And after doing so, like I have many good clients, like the Bollywood celebrities are there, cricketers are there, ministers are there. So after serving a very good clientele and around 500 plus kitchens in 5 years, I moved back to Udaipur because of some personal issues. And me and my wife started a new journey in Udaipur, as Udaipur is more about food. So we thought, why not to start something which is related to food in Udaipur. For that, we did a 6 months first learning that how to do, how to proceed, what all things we want to do, what pros and cons will come, what all things we want to improve and to not to improve, on what Udaipur is serving and what we are not serving. So on studying that for 6 months, then we started our cafe in 2018 May. And with the start, we never thought it will be a huge response, and in a month only we started getting the catering orders for 400 people, and we cater from 100 people to 5000 people pan India, not only in Udaipur, pan India. So that's how our journey started, and it's now it's been we started from 200 feet cafe, and now by starting the journey, after a year we opened another store, and after that just getting the good response, we thought, why not to club both the stores and open a bigger one. So now we opened a bigger cafe with a 1200 square feet area with 40 plus sitting capacity. In that, the best part is you can enjoy the movies, you can enjoy the conferences, you can enjoy workshops, you can play the games, read books and do a lot, and can do parties as well. Foogle is all about food innovations. So our thing is, why not serve innovative food? So we have a food products like puriza, pizza in golgappa, which is the thinnest crust. And we give in smoky flavor to get you feel of the pizza in just a one golgappa. Then we have product like chocolate pani puri. Sometimes we feel that what chocolate pani puri is, it's basically a dessert which is like full of filling, and you feel like you have two more, three more or four more products of that. Then we have some garlitos, which is a masala which is sandwiched in garlic bread. Then we have cheese well full of cheese, and lot more products are there to explore. This is how my journey started, and it's going on. The success mantra of my cafe is every dish is tested. Whenever it is launched, it is tested for 2 to 3 days with every customer. We give it a complimentary food to every customer so that we can get a proper response of the product. By testing on around 10, 20 to 50 people, then we launch the product. And on every product which is served to in the restaurant to every customer, we want feedback of every product, whether the customer is a new one or a repeated customer. Because of that, the customer feels more of a relationship thing,
and more of closeness, and that's how the things works out. By just on our suggestion, customer orders what we want, the customer orders that.
See, when I started my career, I never thought that I will enter into such and such fields after such and such span of time. So my dream was to first become a hacker. I was like fond of hacking earlier, and was like I will become a computer engineer. But the moment I entered the college and studying a lot of things, then I realized that I think I should become an electrical engineer. After completing my studies, I thought that I'll jump into some companies like Hindustan Zinc Limited or any other companies which are linked with power plants. So my dream was like to work with power companies having power plants, huge power plants, to learn more and grow more. It's not like you get what you want in your life. There are a lot and lot of hurdles comes in your life. So you have to choose your steps wisely. So when I started with doing job after my education in a panel manufacturing company, I never thought of doing so. But after that, I switched again to studies and did masters, which I never thought. The best part of my life is I never gave a second thought while moving forward and towards what next to do, what not to do. Just by thinking that I have to do this now, I just switch my job without giving a second thought. And that's how I feel that that's a success part of mine, which always pushes me to grow more and get more success. I don't think that it's a sacrifice, but yes, at the second thought, I can say that it might be a sacrifice that I was I tried to move into a plant, but I never did. I never wanted to go for a teaching job, but I did that. Then I never thought that I will move to Goa to start my new venture, which was like I never thought of. And after that, after giving that hard work and patience and my time towards the new business, then I moved back to Udaipur and started my cafe. So I don't know that it's a sacrifice or not, but yeah, that sacrifice is really a sweet thing what I can say, because now I feel very, very good after moving back to what I think it's my passion to start something new. And I always feel very good in doing some of the other innovative things. No, I am not a born leader, but I inculcated everything by learning from some of the other people. I learned a lot from a lot of people, like how things works, how you used to monitor, how you used to praise people so you can learn more. So that's the strategy I always applied to learn more things in life. See, my role model is, I am my own role model. I don't feel that someone else is my role model, because I learned a lot by getting kicks in my life and then move on further to get something new. So for me, I am the only role model who keep on working by just getting a lot of hurdles and then move forward. The products in which we are serving are like hummus, pita bread, tacos, nachos, garlic bread, garlitos, cheese well, soy biryani, then spicy pizzas are there, vegetable saute is there for healthy people, pasta is there, garlic bread is there, misal pav is there, Maharashtrian food, Mumbai vada pav, proper Mumbai vada pav is there. Then shakes are there. We have a huge variety of shakes and mocktails. Some are experimental and some are common. Now with the current profession what I am handling, I feel like that if I can get back in time, I should become a chef and proceed the things further and take the journey far more better to get a very good result in my current journey. I was born and brought up in Udaipur, and like childhood memories are like I was a very notorious guy earlier. Now also I don't know, but thing is that I was a notorious guy. So for me, like I don't know whether should I share this memory or not, but once during my childhood time, because of that scare problem that the teacher is there who will beat me when I'll go to tuition,
I went under the bed sheets and hid for the entire day. Like since morning till evening, I was in under the bed sheet and entire society was searching for me here and there. And at the end, when all people thought that now it's not happening and we can't find him, they decided to went to police station to check whether we can search him or not. Someone from the colony somehow managed to came to the storeroom where the bed sheets and bed other things were there, and he found out that what something is bulging out from the bed sheet. So after that they found me, and that was the memory I carry, which is like which was the best memory I think I had. For me, the fun time is like whenever I am like free at cafe and I enter kitchen, I feel like I should innovate something new today. So that's how I feel more aggressive, more positive and more motivated towards my work. And secondly, to relax somehow, I love to watch Hollywood movies a lot. Education is equally important in life because education is the best part which gives you a broader view. If you are good and highly educated, then you can take a risk and responsibility of doing something new, and you can take a good risk to start a new business, because business is not an easy task for anyone to start with. So education at a very good level gives you a good exposure, and at the same time experience helps you to become a more better person. Thank you everyone for listening to my story, and I hope you all liked it. And if you liked it, do like, subscribe and share. If you think you have some more stories which you feel like that can be shared on this platform and can motivate some of the other people to make their success stories, please post them. Thank you so much.